its importance. Let's talk about scale in your work, because some of your work is not large, and some of your work is extremely large. I think the piece in England is 60 feet, approximately.
20 meters.
20 meters, yeah, so 60 feet.
60
yeah.
feet, yeah.
Hi. Tell me about scale.
Well, I guess I told you by phone when we talked yeah. the other day that I never forgot. One day I was having dinner with Anthony Caro, which was a very important British sculptor, a very good professor. He was always trying to teach, and he was a lovely man. And we were talking about the scale, and suddenly he said, Jaume, it's three very important things in sculpture, scale, scale, scale. and I completely agree with him. Probably I disagree with him in the way to apply those three principles, because for me scale doesn't mean necessary size or weight. For me scale means the proportion with the rest. How to explain that, I don't know exactly. But it's in terms of emotions, in terms of relationship. I don't know, many times an art piece has not the scale and it's just a simple text made in one wall. But probably it was better in the normal scale, in one paper, and reading, in, sitting in one chair. It was not necessary to amplify the sign. I guess the scale is the relationship between you and the shapes that you are creating, you and your ideas. Many times I'm defending the brain as the wildest place in our body, because it's completely out of our control. Many times when people say, no, he has a good brain, he's a very rational person, I said, but it's completely wrong. The wildest part is the brain. And in the brain, all our recalls, all our memories has the same size. It's like an archive with all, everything is so little and in. What means a scale in our memories? And but when you are talking in probably more physically, why in Madison the piece had this size, or in England the other? Is I'm so good with the scale, I have to say. And I'm always right. Why? I don't know. But I could explain you the little history with the Crown Fountain, for example, that I remember after 2 years working with the plan, the technical design, the drawings, the plans, it was a big meeting in the office of Mr. Lester Crown, who was so lovely supporting the project. And finally we did the meeting and with the estimates for the project. Okay, and somebody said, well, Mr. Crown is $17 million. Mr. Crown said, well, wow, Mr. Plenser, we were expecting five, maybe 10, but 17. Could you imagine, or do you mind to reduce the piece of the And I said, well, if you have the capacity to reduce Chicago, I could reduce the piece. Because the piece is in the right scale. Okay, it was a terrible night for me, obviously. The day after, some of the Crown family came to my hotel to say, Jaume, don't worry, we will do it. But the scale was perfect.